Hey everybody, Mike Linville here from Black Dog Education with this week's installment of Office Hours, where we answer your questions about web design, web development, and online marketing. Now this week, Ashley writes, Mike, I'm getting ready to start a website redesign project and I'm not really sure how the whole process works. Do I need to back up my data? Should I be making copies of my files? I'm not really sure. Can you give me some ideas? Now, Ashley, that's a great question. You know, website redesign projects, they used to be an administrative nightmare, right? Because there's a couple of things that we want to be able to do that are kind of counterintuitive to each other. The first thing that we want to do is we want to make sure that the new website is available online, right? It's web readable, web accessible. So that way the client can look at the site, they can review it, they can make comments and do whatever tweaks that they need to do before the site goes live. The other side of that though is we don't want to take the old site down, right? Because depending upon the size of the project, a website redesign could take 6, 8, 10 weeks, depending upon how large it is. And you don't want your website to be down for that long. People can't find your phone number, they can't get a hold of you. That's not a good thing either, okay? So there are ways around that, but depending upon the host of the new host, the old host, it can get a little time consuming and it can get a little bit cumbersome, okay? So we weren't happy with either of those solutions. So what we did is we came up with a new streamlined process, and it's actually pretty cool because it works out that it's actually faster and cheaper than the old method, and I like it a lot, okay? So we're gonna come up with some sort of a cool name for it, but that's neither here nor there. Now, to be able to understand this, what we're gonna have to do is put our little school hats back on and go back and revisit two ideas or two topics about Web 101. The first one we're gonna do is we're gonna talk about your website. Now remember, your website, right? All of the files, the pages, the graphics, the databases, the forms, everything, they all live on a server somewhere on the internet. And that location is identified by what's called an IP address, right? That's enough for people to be able to find your website if they just have that number. The problem is that looks horrible on business cards, okay? So that's where we come up with the second topic, which is domain names. Now, what a domain name does is a domain name is really just a pointer, right? It's just a record in a database somewhere that says, when somebody types in this name, send them over to that server, right? That's all it does is it points the name over to the server. That's how your domain name and your web host are connected. Sometimes people think they're like one in the same. They're actually not. They're separate elements, okay? So when we do a website redesign, what we're gonna do is we're really gonna do just three steps. The first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna register a brand new domain name. If you can get it close to your existing domain name, you know, get maybe a .net instead of a .com or put a hyphen somewhere in it, that's cool. Doesn't really matter. It's gonna be temporary, okay? The second thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and do the development, the new domain name on the new host site, okay? And then the third thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and redirect the old domain, the original domain, back over to the new site when we're ready, okay? Now the cool part about that is it lets us go ahead and do the development where the site is ultimately gonna live. So we don't have any migration issues, any software discrepancies or anything else like that. It lets us keep the old website up and running while you're doing the redesign. And so, you know, if the project runs a little bit long, you don't really have to worry about that. And if you're worried about somebody stopping by or stumbling across the new site, you know, if you're doing a WordPress redesign, for example, which I recommend since it's WordPress month, you can use something like a plugin, like maintenance mode. And what that does is for people that aren't logged in as administrators, it'll just show a nice, well, you know, a good looking coming soon page. Everybody else that has the login information will go ahead and see the site and they can do whatever they need to do, okay? The best part about this whole thing, super easy to set up, and it only costs like 10 bucks or whatever the cost of a domain name is, right? 8 bucks if you've got a coupon, okay? So Ashley, I hope that has actually helped you. I hope that has served you. If you have any additional questions like this, please make sure that you submit them over on our Facebook wall. If you like this video, like it, share it, pass it around to your friends, put in some comments down below, okay? This is Mike Linville from Black Dog Education. I wanna say thank you for stopping by and we'll see you next time.